proportions. You've said that word over and over in math. You think usually what you have to do is to solve. Well, we've been simplifying stuff. We have not been solving. Actually, today is the first day we are going to solve something, okay? Namely, for proportions, we don't simplify proportions. What we do is we solve them, okay? So the next topic is how to solve proportions. What does Dr. Sutcliffe mean by solving a proportion? What is that? Let's just start with a simple example, okay? And then, of course, I'll teach you the fast way. But for now, what I mean by solving a proportion is if I have, let's say, a half, okay? And trust me, you'll learn some algebra even in 105.
Okay.
Oh, Sabrina is very excited. So if I have, let's say, x over 8. Where is the algebra here? Why did I promise algebra?
Yeah,
because now you see an x.
Four.
When you say solve a proportion, the problem really is to find x, right? Guys, relax, please. Can I have the floor?
Let her teach her class.
Okay. We have this, this is a, I'm claiming this is a proportion, right? For this to be a proportion, we have to find the correct value of x, okay? And I started with an easy example, and I know some of you know the answer right away already, right? Okay? How can a half be the same as x over 8? For what value of x will this work? And you will have a true proportion. How many say what?
Four.
How many see 4? Do you guys see 4? Yeah, because half is the same as 4/8, right? So by eyeballing, you just look, right? You say, oh, if you are a 4, right? Correct? You just eyeball, you say, oh, if that's a 4, then 4/8 is the same as a half. Correct? Right? Did anybody else do it a different way? Did you just look? Did you just eyeball?
Yeah.
All right, so you just eyeball. You want to do another example of eyeballing?
Yes.
All right, so just eyeball, okay? So let's say I have 3/5, and the x I can actually put down below, okay? I can put a 9 over x. Can we still eyeball? Well, think of the first example. How did you get a 4?
X equals 15?
9.
Who said that?
I did.
Okay, what did you do? What did you do? Did you eyeball?
I just said 3x equals 45 and figure out what x was.
Yeah, oh, you're doing the algebra now, okay? The one way of eyeballing this is you look at, remember what we did for fractions? What you do to the bottom, you have to do to the top, right? So like in the first example, how did 2 become an 8?
2 times 4 is 8.
2 times 4 is 8. Therefore, you have to multiply this by 4. Correct? So that's the eyeballing that happened. 1 times 4 is 4. Correct? Okay? So one way you can do it is to look at this. 3 became 9. How did 3 become a 9?
Times 3.
You had to multiply by 3.
Times 5.
Right? Therefore, if you multiply the numerator by 3, you also have to multiply the denominator by 3. So you get how much is your x? 15. So you say that x has to be 15. But of course, I'm sure you don't like that method because it requires a lot of looking and thinking, right? Okay? Ready? So what is the quick way of doing this that requires some algebra?
Extremes and means.
That's the reason why we explained extremes and means. Okay? So what's another way instead of eyeballing because it kind of gets tiring to eyeball, right?
5 times 9 is 40.
Wait. 3. You have a half equals x over 8. You draw your airplane, right? Can you do that? Yeah, my book doesn't know that yet, but in the future I can do this now. I know how to do this, okay? So this means that 2 times x, in algebra, 2 times x is written as 2x. Are you okay?
Yes.
Are you freaking out?
How are you?
All right?
Feeling good?
That's really 2 times x okay? Because that's what we do, right? We multiply.
Equals
1 times 8. How much is 1 times 8?
8.
You understand? All right? And I claim that even if you don't know algebra, you can figure out that what number do you multiply to 2 to get 8?
4.
4, right? Okay? But because you don't want to do a lot of thinking later on because the problems will get harder, I'll show you the algebraic way to do it. Ready? What do you think I will do to 2 times x equals 8 so I will get? I divide both sides by 2. Aren't you excited we're doing algebra?
Love it.
Okay. You can divide both sides by 2. What will happen to the 2 twos?
Slash.
Slash, right? Correct? So then you get x on the left, and how much is 8 over 2?
4.
It takes longer, but you know, but after a while it becomes mechanical. So why don't you do the next one while I'm erasing the board? See that? Where this came from, right? Our quiz will only be up to here. I didn't get to do the fancy problems. Okay, we'll do that next time. What will be your divisor here?
3.
3. It's the one that's sitting in front of the x, right? The multiplier. So then you get chop, you get x equals how much is 45 divided by 50? Did you guys get it?
Yes.
It's not hard, right? Okay. Let's see if this is hard. So what will happen? What's going to sit on the left? 9x. And on the right, it's what?
108.
Instead of making it 108, I want to leave it as 4 times 27. Why do you think I resisted 108?
It's huge,
right? Okay? I don't like 108. To me, that's a big number already. Why do you think I'm okay to do that? Because what's the next step after that? I divide by 9. And do you see the wisdom of not changing it to 108?
What's the difference?
What is the wisdom of keeping the 27?
9 times 3.
It's easy to chop, right? Okay, so that's one lesson I want to impart to you before the week is over, right? Okay. Rather than deal with big numbers, you might be able to chop later on, right? So leave them first. So therefore, the answer here is x equals, Shanika, can you help me? This will chop, right? 27 and 9 will be 3, right?
Yes.
So the answer is?
X equals
12. Did you get 12?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, let's say you solve 108 first. How do you figure out 12 for 108?
It's the same. If you had insisted on 108, you get 108 over 9. So what do?
Divide.
You get the same answer, right? Okay. So you divide 108 by 9, right?
Thank you.
You get 12. You're welcome. Have a nice weekend, guys. Study, okay? So your quiz will come from 4.1, okay? For Tuesday.
Tuesday?
Tuesday.